पहली नज़र में ऐसा लगेगा जैसे कि हम भारत के किसी म्यूज़ियम में खड़े हैं, लेकिन नहीं, ये है लंदन का ब्रिटिश म्यूज़ियम, जहाँ यहाँ पैंडेमिक के बाद खुलते ही पहली एग्जीबिशन लगी है तंत्र के ऊपर, तंत्र एनलाइटनमेंट टू रेवोल्यूशन। कोशिश है ब्रिटिश म्यूज़ियम की कि किस तरह से तंत्र का सफ़र रहा है, फिलॉसफी किस तरह से आगे बढ़ी है, इवॉल्व हुई है, उसको दिखाया जा सके। शिव शक्ति का क्या संबंध है और नेचर के साथ, हमारी जितनी खूबसूरत नेचर है उसके साथ किस तरह से तंत्र अपने आप को जोड़ता है। कहीं ना कहीं वेस्ट में ये मानना है कि तंत्र संभोग या सेक्सुअल एक्टिविटी के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है और इस तरह की मिथ है उसके बारे में। भारत में कहीं ना कहीं ब्लैक मैजिक से कभी ना कभी उसे जोड़ दिया जाता है, लेकिन इस एग्जीबिशन की कोशिश है कि इन सभी तरह की जो मिथ्स हैं उनको तोड़ा जाए और वाकई तंत्र क्या कहना चाहता है इस बात को दर्शाया जाए।
As a philosophy is really misunderstood in the West. Here it's usually equated with sex, isn't it? Almost as a cult of sexual ecstasy. It's really, really been misunderstood. That actually goes back to the colonial times when some of the earliest tantric texts were translated into English and totally misunderstood. So this exhibition is an attempt to set the record straight and really communicate to our audiences what Tantra is. And of course, Tantra is a philosophy, it's an Indian philosophy, which affirms that all of material reality is a manifestation of Shakti, or divine feminine energy, or power. So we wanted to communicate this through a history of Tantra as a philosophy, right from around the 6th century AD until the present day, and explore how it's been a revolutionary force throughout history.
Because a very interesting name, I have to say, enlightenment to revolution. What is it that brings out of Tantra which is relevant to this world and that you want people to respond to?
I think the emphasis on feminine power is very relevant today, that focus on female empowerment, because Tantra not only inspired the rise of goddess worship in medieval India, the impacts of which we see in India today, but it also affected the lives of real women. So women could play really important roles as independent practitioners in their own right. But also, according to tantric texts, women as embodiments of Shakti are superior gurus or teachers. So tantric texts teach that we must venerate women as goddesses in their own right. So I think this had a huge impact on the feminist movement in India as well as in the West. And we still have valuable lessons to learn from that. And I think also in terms of the ecological crisis that we find ourselves in, Tantra teaches that our world, everything in it, is sacred and we need to protect it. So in the 60s and 70s, Tantra had a big impact on the environmental movement in the West. And I think today, more than ever, we can learn lessons from Tantra about the need to protect our world as sacred.
प्रभाव डाला है तंत्र ने, और नेचर, क्लाइमेट चेंज जिसकी हम बात करते हैं उस पर भी काफ़ी गहराई से बात की है तांत्रिक फिलॉसफी ने, और इन सब को संजो के इस एग्जीबिशन के जरिए पेश किया है ब्रिटिश म्यूज़ियम ने। लवीना टंडन, ब्रिटिश म्यूज़ियम, लंदन।